Ulysses S. Grant Elementary School, created in 1910, and the first class that started was in 1911. When you think of Grant, you think of wonderful staff, very, very encouraging and supportive surrounding community. A lot of our students walk to school. Our parents spend a lot of time on our grounds and in the building, and so that's a huge part of it.
I am Matt Kuensting, and I'm a fifth grade teacher at Grant Elementary School. I've taught there for 15 years. We've got kids from everywhere on the planet, and they all are there to do the same thing, to learn, and they all get along, and it works. It's not magic, but it feels like it sometimes, because the way that they all want to do well and do what's right is really impressive. It makes it a special place.
Our main focus is always, how can we enhance the lives of our students? I often tell parents that when your student comes to Grant, they have not just one teacher, they have the whole school full of teachers.
I mean, it's a very thoughtful, close-knit group. As I said, creating the magic of Grant every day. Because, again, with the diversity that's there from economics to where you came from, you just don't see it everywhere.
We've also really focused on a positive environment that includes an awareness of mindfulness and of self-regulation, strong academics, and then, of course, most successfully this last year with a wonderful construction opportunity going on around us. And so we have these different missions that we keep going forth, but mainly it is to create a culture where students are empowered and they are valued, and that we welcome everyone into our community. In 2016, we really started the frequent meetings, and then the crew officially came in May of 2017 and have been daily added bonus to our school ever since.
As we were finishing up 2 years ago, one of our big science projects, John's like, you know, we need to start thinking about, well, how we're going to capture the changes at Grant. And I was like, yeah, that'd be awesome.
I'm John, Mr. Nies, they know me, or Lord Teacher Mr. Nies at Grant Elementary School. And I've been teaching in Columbia Public Schools for 17 years now, and it's been 12 of those at Grant. The project really started in the spring of 2017 with Sean, the director of CAD TV. We had a few kids come down and train.
And so John and you all had the forethought to think, well, let's get some kids from fourth grade to be ready to go.
We actually started with 10. There were 5 fifth graders and 5 fourth graders. And the idea was always then the following year we would train all of the fifth graders. And they were really excited about it. And they were able to collect some initial footage of Grant before all the construction happened. About 45 kids, I think, in all, is how many were trained in 1 year, which is very impressive.
So even our fifth graders that were leaving, they were excited about it. They knew the change was coming, and they were kind of bummed. They were the last class that was going to be at Grant before the renovation, and we kind of sold them on that. And so when they began their footage, they were a big part of that. What did it look like before? And the fact that we've given them practical experience on the equipment, and they got to take it back and are part of a history, a legacy item of sorts, was inspiring to them. They knew they wanted to do it right away.
The idea was to capture the construction through the kids' eyes, because with the construction, you know, we had asked kids their opinions on this and that, and mostly they'd said they want swings for the playground, which they've been saying now for about 2 decades. But however, there were community meetings, and parents got to say what they wanted to say, and teachers got to say what they wanted to say, but there was no real formalized way for the kids to share their opinions. And so we thought this would be a neat idea to capture the kids' point of view of the changes that Grant was going through.
Because our parents can pick us up easier and drop us off easier.
And it won't be
chaotic.
I could not have been more impressed with how this all worked out, because you have some expectations about trying to facilitate a learning environment for 300 plus kids and all the staff that come and, you know, want to do their best, and yet having dozens of construction workers throughout the building doing things from hammering a nail, which sounds so innocent, but then it gets really loud and then it impedes learning. And so there were some challenges in terms of noise. And so what that looked like is I would go to the man in charge, Brian Stockman, and I would just say, you know what, this is impacting our learning. And he would say, well, we'll go to another area. That's totally fine. So whenever we face a challenge, there was almost every single time a resolution that was best for everybody. And so we kind of tried to balance when they were in classrooms and with social areas with children, that they would be a part of our school as opposed to an outsider.
Has the construction outside, has it ever distracted you?
Sometimes, but not too often. Not really often.
We're outside, we can hear it a lot better, but they haven't been doing it as much in class.
Just a little.
What are the noises that you've heard?
Like baby noises,
Everybody did more than they were asked to last year. I think that goes without saying. Everybody is on board with a project like this. And I think that speaks to the employees in our school and around the district as well. And those are also the people that make some of the strongest connections with our students. So being able to go and talk to our chefs in the cafeteria, our spending time with Mr. Terry and getting help from Mr. Terry, those are things that's all a part of a positive school experience.
It takes a huge village, and the office staff was really flexible in terms of, I would often say, like, can you reach out to the crew and say this? Or can you make sure this happens? Our custodial staff had minutes of turnaround between gym time and lunchtime and vice versa. And everyone just did it. Everyone stepped up. Everyone did it with like a positive tone and a positive attitude.
And that's another credit to Dr. Wingert and just everyone at Grant School that, you know, it's not every school that has construction ongoing while you're trying to learn.
Little Dixie has been tremendous to work with. They are our family now. They've come and read in classrooms. They've come and talked about what building plans look like and how it gets constructed. I mean, they are so important to us. And so I think that is a must. We couldn't have gotten along so well if we didn't really have value in each other's mission and their job. So we will miss them. Like, I may not miss all the cars and some of the smells and some of the noise. I won't miss that, but I will miss the people. And I think that would be said from anyone at our school. And so that was an unexpected bonus to this whole process. Yeah.
Little Dixie actually contracted us out. We've worked with Little Dixie a couple times before. They're really nice people to work with, and they make sure that everything is safe and sound and working smoothly.
Do you ever like come up with any obstacles when you're trying to do things? Like,
yeah, like this morning we have to put rebar or threads on the ceiling so we can hang a big metal plate from it, and we couldn't reach it. That was a problem. Have you fixed it?
Yeah.
Got a longer rod.
There are definitely some aspects that are challenging. You've got to really be on your toes when it comes to fractions and math and things like that. Taking proper measurements and making sure you're doing proper cuts and being precise with your cuts really keeps you paying attention to detail.
Yeah, why is there sometimes like a smell?
Have you seen them yellow things out there? Have you seen those?
The portage.
Whenever they come, pump them out, that's when it stinks. And when they do that, I gotta go up the job trailer.
Yeah.
I don't like that smell.
It's pretty bad.
It's pretty bad.
Got it.
gotta go away.
So I actually go away for about 10 minutes.
They were very cooperative, and whenever anybody asked a question, they were more than helpful. From, you know, throwing the playground balls back over the fence to, you know, just talking to the kids. So it was pretty much like they were a part of our community for that year.
The benefit of seeing it as it was happening was that students could experience the whole process.
And asking if the gentleman would explain to us, you know, where the mixture comes from that makes the mortar or makes the cement. And so we were able to go back in the classroom and talk more about natural resources being turned into capital resources, which is a big part of our curriculum. And so we took advantage of opportunities that we wouldn't have been able to otherwise.
You know, it wasn't just fifth grade. I mean, I think that was the whole school that was able to just kind of embrace it and know, especially these fourth, third, these kiddos that can come back this year, know that they're gonna see something great and new and different. And that's really exciting.
Is it interesting to watch the elevator being built?
Yes, because you'll see it, and then when it's really done, you'll be like, wow, I can't believe it actually used to look like this.
Because I get to see a lot of things that I normally never get to see.
The cranes, how they have big things, and it just looks really cool.
Because I have no clue what anything is going to be. And it's going to be a good surprise. I am excited.
I'm really excited. One of my favorite things is I hear we're going to get some really cool new art supplies for art, and I'm going to be really excited for the gym extension.
Well, I think it's just so much cooler because there's going to be more space, and so more space for the specials, and we won't have to be outside of the trailers or stuff like that. And also, there'll be more room in them for the classrooms, and you could see and learn more.
Like I said earlier, the expectations, I didn't really know what to have. I was a little concerned about how we were going to be in this really tight space, all of us together. But it was really important for the staff and I to go in with this amazing attitude of flexibility and this ability to be able to take this experience and learn from it. My expectations were exceeded. Like, it was wonderful.
So we've really been trying to have the kids get out in the community more and find more community connections, whether it's a partnership with the project or whether it's just visiting businesses downtown. We've been visiting conservation places around the city. And the whole idea is to latch onto the kids' passions and have them find out things that they're interested in. So we thought that this would be a good way to kind of harness and support some of those passions in the classroom.
John gets a lot of credit because he had the vision, and he kind of looked at it, what do we want to capture? And what, you know, obviously the construction is big, but what makes Grant, Grant?
We were, like I said, creating an important product for our school, a big project that we were doing. So it was kind of like jumping in with a little bit of guidance. And I think what comes out of that are some challenges, but also some unexpected successes for sure.
My name is Pam Sisson, and I am the music teacher here at Grant.
I am the homeschool communicator. My name is Mr. Gaudier.
I am Mrs. Jacoby, and I teach third grade here at Grant.
Well, around here they call me Mr. McKee, but my real name is Bruce Wayne.
I'm Batman.
My name is Ms. Grove, and I've been at Grant for 4 years, going on my fifth year, and I am a kindergarten teacher here at Grant.
I'm a fifth grade teacher. I've taught here for 17 years, most of the time at Grant, most of the time in fifth grade with Mr. Kuensting, and that's mostly what I do.
My name is Lisa Wagner, and I'm the PE teacher here at Grant. I also am in the cafeteria doing lunch duty, and I push into the kindergarten classes and help a little bit in their classrooms as well.
Well, my name is Mrs. Hartz. My first name is Jennifer, and I teach second grade at Grant School. I think the construction is great. Looks like it's coming along really well.
I think the construction is awesome, and it's really going to improve our school because we're going to have so much more space. We won't have to be on top of each other all the time with sharing space. And also, it'll be awesome that Ms. Sisson and Ms. Christensen will have their own classroom.
I'm really excited about the construction plans. I think Dr. Wingert and Ms. Hughes and the construction team has done a really nice job
And I'm really excited to see what it looks like when it's finished, and I think it'll just make a better grant than we have now.
You know, for a guy like me, I go out, you know, and fight crime at night. You know, going up those stairs gets to be hard work, so then putting in that elevator is going to pay huge dividends for me and save my legs.
It's great that Columbia Public Schools and the community is supporting this great school, because it truly is still a neighborhood school where kids get to play on the playground before school and after school. So it's, I think, a very unique school, so I think it's a great contribution to the community.
Been impacted too much. I think the only thing is just getting around the building. You can only really go outside one way. Sometimes when I'm teaching, we hear loud bangs or we hear noises, but you know, it really hasn't affected my students, and they seem to be able to work right through it. So I think just the in and out of Grand and kind of maneuvering around and going different ways is really the only thing that's made it a little different this year, but I'm excited.
Oh my goodness. I am here in the Music Mansion, and I feel like I've been sitting on the lay down yard of the construction site, because all kind of activities are going on right outside my door. They're stacking cement blocks, equipment is driving back and forth, there's all kind of beeping. I just about hear everything that's going on. So it's impacted me a lot, but I truly enjoy it.
It's impacted me pretty well. You know, seeing that, you know, pavement area go. I've never cried so much in my life, but you know, I had to go for the new building to see part of the playground go away too, especially my favorite pieces of it, you know, the mulch area, some of the jungle gym. It impacted me much, but I know it's for a good cause. It's going to be good.
Well, I have to say, for kindergarten, because it's the first year, they don't really know the difference between noise and no noise. They've actually transitioned in very well, and they're not affected by the noise whatsoever. I will say that there are some days when Miss Grove can hear the noise. I had a kiddo this year say he came in and they were all working and the construction workers were really working, and he goes, "They're really working hard today, Miss Grove." And I'm like, "Yes, they are." So it's been an experience, but a good one, because the end result will be good.
I really feel like the construction hasn't affected my teaching a whole lot. The only thing that's a little different is I'm super short on space this year, as everybody else in the building is. And so we really just have to work together to maximize the small space that we have on the stage.
Well, we're kind of over here away from the construction, so it really hasn't bothered us that much. We aren't affected by the noise or other things. So a little bit when they took out some concrete in the front of the building, we could hear some of that noise, but the noise in the main building we really couldn't hear.
I think it's mostly been in a positive way. I mean, we got this project going, you know, which that the whole purpose of this project came to through the construction. How has it impacted me? Probably the same as you all. It takes a little bit longer to get to recess, takes a little bit longer to get back. But the benefit of the neat things that we're able to do and see outweighs any of the challenges that we've had.
I think that having everybody in one building will be nice. So the second grade, Ms. Sisson, I think having new classrooms will be exciting for Grant. Having more than one bathroom will be nice for teachers and students, so we can be a little more spread out. I'm excited to have soon a cafeteria and a gym. And so I think it's just gonna make our school that much more awesome. So I'm really excited to be here next year when it's all ready to go.
Well, I think the goal is to get everybody indoors, inside together, and to get rid of the trailers. And I know that the trailers are very costly, and so it'll be great for everybody to be inside the building together.
You know, we got more space. You know, there's no teachers outside anymore, and I call them cabins. You know, we're all in here. We're gonna be a good family. Now we don't have to walk 8 miles to go, you know, to music class anymore, or fifth graders don't have to go trek in Antarctica when it really snows. They can just go straight in the building and not have to keep running in and out of outside. So I think it'll be good. I think that the improvements will be a great thing for us.
I do believe that the construction will improve the school. We'll have a new piece of the school. We'll have more classrooms. The specialists will not have to be in trailers, nor will second grade and fifth grade. So I think that overall it will be a great addition to our community.
I think the biggest thing is that we're going to have a nice, healthy classroom for every student. We always say at Grant that we're happily crowded. Well, now we're just going to be happy. We're not going to be too crowded, so that's really nice. I think it'll help kids as learners, for sure. So I think we'll be able to do more and achieve more, and we'll be able to host more events because we have cafeteria and the gym being separate. So I think it's going to impact us in a positive way.
I think the construction will be wonderful. We'll all be in the same building, and yes, I think it will be a nice improvement for the students and teachers of Grant School.
I'm going to be able to have the instruments more accessible to the kids. I think we're going to have a lot of space and a lot of nice wall space. And so I think that it's going to be easier for us maybe to use our instruments when we go inside.
I think it'll definitely improve the school. I think it's going to be a lot more space for us to teach the classes. I think our new cafeteria and gymnasium is going to be very helpful to those ladies. I think it's just going to be great.
I am getting a new classroom. My new classroom will be classroom 119 in the new building. And I was able to see it. It has a bathroom and it has very tall ceilings and it's a very spacious room. Yeah.
Well, you know, if I get a new classroom, I wouldn't mind. You know, as long as we have, I want it to be about 2,400 square foot. I want, you know, my own office room, you know, with about 3 big screen TVs, 2 recliners in case I want friends to come over. You know, hardwood floors. I want all my kids to have couches and, you know, love seats and recliners. And then those recliners have a little tabletop thing they can fold over.
Our community really values our playground. And that's just not even during the school year necessarily, it's also during the summer. It's those trees were there from before we were, you know, before the building was there, and so to then take it down, and there's a sense of loss. So I remember standing there and looking at the construction guy who was doing it, and I said, if there's any way we can save any of this, please do. Well, the trees were well rooted into the ground, so that was pretty hard, but needed. But you know, you have this sense of loss.
What's the most exciting part of the construction, in your opinion?
The playground. I expect swings and more room to run around.
Swing sets, new slides, and more monkey bars.
More blacktop, better playgrounds and four square.
So big and fancy and like a lot of polish and stuff.
Arrival and dismissal are some of the best parts of the day because that's when you get to see every single person who comes to school. Sometimes it's hard to get in every classroom every day, but we truly value the morning arrival time. And so every morning, Mr. Godier and myself go out and we greet, he greets the buses and I greet the car riders. And it's a way to say hello to families, to families' pets, to upcoming siblings, and to kind of be the first face of happiness that students are greeted every single day by name when they come out of the car. That helps the sense of community and the sense of I feel, students knowing that someone is more than eager to open your door and greet you in the morning. So that is how we start every morning. Rain, snow, ice, hot, you know, anything, any temperature, we're out there. And it's invaluable. And that will not change in terms of someone being out there to greet them. And so during construction, it didn't change either. And then with our new change, we'll have a circle drive, and that'll be where cars will drop off. And again, children will be greeted every single day, and our buses will continue on Garth. And then dismissal, I always stand at the gate to wish everyone a good day and see them off. And we will now go back dismissing on the playground, which allows this really important community interaction that has been missing for a year. Parents will be there, we hope, until 5 or 6 at night. Oftentimes I leave from work or staff leave from work and parents and students are still playing. And that's our goal. That's what we want for them. When we took a tour, when the staff finally got to see before the year ended, our art teacher was so excited. Our music teacher's tickled with how much space she has, and she gets to stay inside. I think our staff are really excited about being all together in the building, which is a new, wonderful thing. To know the Grant Playground is to know that when you want to play soccer and it's rained in the last month, it's kind of muddy. And now we have this new turf that's going to be coming down where kids can play soccer all the time, which the kids will love. And then lots of Foursquare. And then to also kind of cherish our shaded area or our area with our picnic tables and benches where parents could be as well, we will have those areas also built in. And so we're kind of getting our feel back into what Grant is used to having. Some really great added features. We have a brick walkway. We did a brick campaign. And so to read the different messages that people have ordered on these bricks are incredibly touching. And they span almost the entire history of Grant School. Alumni from the very beginning, their families have bought them a brick. It tells a whole story about kind of the love people have once they leave.
The best part about being at Grant School that I still have my best friend.
Well, we always thought we were the best school in town. And there were 5 schools at that time.
Yeah, there was Lee, Ridgeway, Benton, Field,
and Grant.
The office is exciting. We are all now tile, which is a beautiful lightning airy sense that's added to the hallways and the classrooms. It may seem like a small thing, but it's really beautiful. Green space is really important to us. And then we're also going to have an outdoor classroom seating area with benches and garden beds right where our old trailer used to be by our fire escape. And so we've always been happily crowded. And so we always maximize our space, but now we can maximize our space in a less crowded way, if that makes sense. And so we want to utilize our open spaces for students and teachers and staff to really be outside and benefit from in a way that kind of speaks to our desire of having the environment close to us, having environmental responsibilities such as gardening and keeping our grounds really clean. So those things are going to come back, and that's going to be a really added bonus.
Kids are going to know and remember this. Like, I can always say the class of 2017-18, this is their heirloom item. This is what they did. We have all of this because of the work that they did. So that's a huge success. Again, kids' confidence, kids that maybe didn't always thrive in the classroom were able to be outside the classroom doing something they enjoyed. They had that connection to Grant School. You could just see their confidence grow. So, you know, at the beginning it was muddling and turning of dials and wondering and looking, and then not turning on the sound or not turning on volume, or, you know, and then slowly but surely kids were starting to be like, you know, they had their own little checklist. But we really did see that growth from the beginning of the year till the end of the year.
The biggest success is the project itself. We have some students that have continued interest in the media and in working with Cat TV. We had kids talking to construction workers. They may not have ever talked to a construction worker before. I remember ending the year with a math project of how many bricks are there on Grant School, because that was a question that one of our interviewers asked a bricklayer, and the bricklayer, he just kind of said, oh yeah, it's about this many. And we had to do all kinds of formulas to figure it out, and I don't even think we came up with an exact answer. But so we had opportunities to bring some of it into our normal day-to-day curriculum. As an educator, I know that the environment that I'll be teaching in next year is much more supportive of learning than the mobile classrooms were, for sure.
I think that whether we have a new building or our original building, every time something is added, it only allows us to have an enhancement in some way or another. But the underlining qualities that never seem to change are the fact that every kid is known in our school families are super important. The staff's main goal is to provide a safe and enriching environment for everyone to learn and to collaborate, and that we value our traditions and the people that come to our school every single day. So no matter if it's a new building or an old building, those elements of Grant School are just as strong and are just as life impacting as ever. And I think that you can see that through when we have our yearly events like Finesta or our Evening of the Arts or Arts and Blues. Alumni want to come in. People are having a really great time. It brings out so many of our families. And so those are things that matter. And so it's making sure that we provide a space for those things to still be fostered. And new is beautiful, but every single thing that happens in our school happens because the people that come to work every single day and want to be a part of it. And so that's the coolest part about Grant School.
Who's your favorite student?
My favorite student.
My favorite student?
Mm-hmm. All of them.
Well, I guess my favorite student would have to be me, because I am learning things from you guys all of the time. So you're never too old to be a student.
It's a 300-way tie for first.
Yeah.
Well, I really want to go to the beach this summer, so I'm taking a donation. So maybe the kiddo that gives me the most money for my trip would be my favorite.
Well, you know, I like to race, so, you know, whoever brings me the most money to buy a race car so I can go be famous, I'll pick that student.
I would have to say my whole group is my favorite. I have a really good group this year, and I have to say, over the last 4 years, I've had great kids too. So I think all my kids.
Oh, my favorite student is definitely...
All of my students are my favorite students.
By the way, who's your favorite student?
Oh, well, you were my favorite student, Liam, of course. Yeah. Doesn't that sound right? Yeah.
All right, well, my last question, I guess, is who's your favorite student?
Oh, well, you know who that is. It's you, Sean.
Hey, I'm waiting for somebody to say that.
Oh, well, that's an easy one. You know the answer to that, don't you? It's you, Herman.
Yeah.
Now, wait, can I ask you a question? Who's your favorite teacher?